If you want to start a business, first of all, it starts from the idea. The best ideas are the ones from frustration. Most successful businesses in the world came as a result of an opportunity they identified. The most important thing to do is to assess the feasibility of that business. And in assessing the feasibility, you have to know if the timing is right for you to enter that business. If you have the right business model to enter the market, if you have the right people backing up the business process. So you have to identify your market. That's the most important thing. And that's why it's very easy for celebrities, once they become very big, they open a clothing line or they have a lipstick line or something, because they already have their fan base, and that their fan base is their market. So the most important thing is to identify your market, and then everything you do, you work around satisfying that market. How to take over the market. Business plan is something that is very dynamic. Like, the business plan you started off with is not what you're going to use like 6 months or a year into the business. It's something that keeps changing. So it's a guide. It's with your business plan that you'll be able to go to an investor. It's with the business plan that you'll be able to tell your staff, okay, this is our structure, this is our culture, this is how we're going to go about it. In WPC, when they call it consults, what we actually do, we have this model that we work for you with you. After preparing the business plan, you are free to come back at interval. We'll go through it. We'll check how the business plan is in correlation with the present time and the market, and know how we're going to make it better. So it goes beyond preparing a business plan. We implement. If it's marketing you need to do, we prepare a marketing plan for you. We make recommendations on the best means to reach to your clients, because we've done research and we know where your clients are and how to reach them. The business plan is just a document, but if it cannot be implemented, then it's useless. Personally, I believe businesses are meant to grow. If it's newspaper you're selling, if you're selling for 50 naira, you're not buying for 50 naira. There's already a profit. So it's about how you manage the profits that you make from your business that will determine if you grow or not. From our research, I came to find that most businesses in Nigeria, it's more of family business. This particular family, they might know them with that business, and 10 years, 20 years, they're still doing that business, but it's still on that level. You have to know how to manage your finance. And with managing finance, the most important thing you need to have is discipline. I advise most of my clients, if you have a business, make sure you put yourself on salary, because if you're eating directly from your profits, you wouldn't really know how well the business is going. So I advise most of my clients to place themselves on salary and watch their business grow, because at the end of the day, if it was someone else that was running the business for you, you put the person on salary. The person won't be eating from the business profit. So it's very important, and that's like the most common way that business is run down, because the owners eat directly from their profits. All of us are aware of this adage. It's something about there is no original idea. Whatever it is you're thinking of now, trust me, someone has done it like 50 years ago. People are doing it now, and people will still do it 50 years later. So it's about knowing what you have to offer. If you're entering a market and you think there are a lot of people there already, and that's a reason for you to quit, then you don't know why you want to start that business. It's advisable not even to start it. When you know what you have to offer, you won't be threatened by others. Rather, you'll be enthusiastic about it, because you know that this, my idea is so good that it's going to change the way people think about this particular line of business. I can relate to that, because when they are discussing starting a business in Europe or America, it's different from when they are discussing it here. In Nigeria, our government is not so encouraging, because I have this client, they are doing very well, they have like great strategy and everything, but because of some offices, it's affecting that business. So that could be discouraging, but that's why research is very important, because through your business plan and your research, you're able to foresee all these rough patches you could experience in the future and make plans ahead of it, either to network, make connections, and just know how you're going to avert it before you get to that big. He said that because when you're getting a loan, you're getting it to pay back with interest, and that interest starts immediately the next month. And you know the dynamics of starting a business. If you're starting a business now, you go and borrow 80 million naira, you are setting yourself up for disaster. Even all these multimillionaires and big business people, serial entrepreneurs, if you actually listen to them, most of them didn't start it off borrowing money. They did something, it worked, they already had the traction, they already had the market. So it was more of expansion.
If the business has prospect to make profit.
It has prospects to make profits, but you start paying that interest before the profits start entering. So even with those profits coming in, you are paying off your interest. When you're done paying off interest, you start paying back the loan. So when you even start counting your money, you might need to still borrow another one, and before you know it, it's like a ripple effect. You just keep borrowing like throughout the business life. Okay, how I pay myself 10,000 naira. Okay, for example, the thing you need to make your akara might cost you like 1.5. Let's assume you're making 10,000 naira from your akara every day. You can tell yourself, okay, since this is amount I'm making every day, 10,000 naira from this akara business, and I'll have to spend like 1.5 to 2,000 naira to buy what I need. And the profits you are going to be getting is 8,000 naira. From that 8,000 naira, you could decide to pay yourself 2,000 naira. And with that 2,000 naira, you save the remaining 6,000. You put back the 2,000 naira into the business. And then like that, you go every day, you're bringing out 6,000, you're giving yourself 2,000. And if you check it, in a week, you'll be paying yourself 2 times 7, that's 14K. 14K times 4, you're earning more than some civil servants. You have to be patient. For your business not to die, you have to be patient. And it takes me back to loving what you do. And I could remember when we were starting this show, you said if you're entering a business because you saw your neighbor doing it, you can't, how will you last in that business? Because if you do it for 2 months and you've not hammered that 100,000 naira your neighbor hammered, you'll get discouraged. So it's just about loving what you do, having a passion, sharing that passion, identifying with people that need that solution. And it keeps you hopeful. That passion keeps you hopeful, because it's with that hope you'll be able to navigate through all the negativity you get along the way. All those things, they work hand in hand. There's something they call a pitch deck, like a 10-minute summary of everything an investor needs to know about your business. And in that 10-minute summary, you should be able to describe your business the least way possible, like the easiest way possible. Tell them about your traction, that's the market, and how they will make their money. So with that, you'll be able to convince them, and they might be willing to believe in you and invest in you. My last line to all entrepreneurs, businesses, startups in Nigeria, I can only say, just be patient, be disciplined. Our own country makes it 10 times difficult to do anything, but like, don't let all those things stop you. All we need in this country, hope, and your business will thrive.
Right, thank you so much, Chinwe Dijupe from Wendy College Consults. We really appreciate you coming on the show.
Thanks for having me. Had a great time. Thank you very much.